Captain's log, stardate 43989.1. The Enterprise has arrived at Jure 4 in response to a distress signal from one of the Federation's outermost colonies.
Anything from the surface?
No, sir. There have been no communications from the colony for over 12 hours.
Sensors picking up any signs of life?
None.
The surface environment is safe for transport, men.
Mr. O'Brien,
verify these are accurate coordinates for the New Providence colony.
Coordinates verified, sir.
You're at the center of town.
Lieutenant Commander Shelby of Starfleet Tactical have arrived to review the disappearance of New Providence Colony. No sign remains of the 900 inhabitants.
The truth is, hell, we are not ready. We've known they were coming for over a year. We've thrown every resource we have into this, but still...
Then you're convinced it is the Borg?
That's what I'm here to find out. The initial descriptions of these surface conditions are almost identical to your report from System J25.
Commander Riker wrote those reports. He agrees with you.
Commander Shelby took over Borg tactical analysis 6 months ago. I've learned to give her a wide latitude when I want to get things done. That's how I intend to operate here.
My priority has been to develop any kind of defense strategy.
Obviously, nothing we have now can stop them.
We've been designing new weapons, but they're all still on the drawing board.
We expected much more lead time. Your encounter with the Borg was over 7,000 light years away.
If this is the Borg, it would indicate they have a source of power far superior to our own.
I'd like to see the colony site as soon as possible, Captain.
It'll be dark there in 30 minutes. We've scheduled an away team for dawn.
Number one, why don't you show the commander to our quarters?
It's our poker night, Admiral. There's always an open seat for you.
Another time, Commander. Your captain and I have a lot to cover. But rumor has it Commander Shelby has played a hand or two. Keep your eye on her, Jean-Luc. She's one very impressive young lady.
You seem rather taken with her, JP.
Just an old man's fantasies. When Shelby came into tactical, every admiral's uncle had a take on this Borg business. She cut through it. She put us on track.
Earl Grey?
Please.
She'd make you one hell of a first officer.
Already have a hell of a first officer.
Don't tell me he's going to pass up another commission.
One's available.
The Melbourne. It's his if he wants it. Hasn't he told you?
He'll make a fine captain, JP.
You may want to tell him that. We're still waiting on his decision. This is the third time we pulled out the captain's chair for Riker. He just won't sit down. Well, let me tell you something, Jean-Luc. There are a lot of young hotshots like Shelby on the way up. Riker could suddenly look like he's standing still next to them. He's hurting his career by staying put. And if I were you, I'd kick him in the rear end for his own good.
I don't know exactly what I'm looking for, but we've tested the sections of the Enterprise's hull that were damaged by the Borg. There were some unusual magnetic resonance traces.
A Borg footprint?
That's my theory. I'll see if it holds up tomorrow. I've reviewed your personnel. I'll be assigning Mr. LaForge and Mr. Data to accompany me on the away team.
I've already assigned them to the away team. And I'll be with you as well, Commander.
Of course. I appreciate any assistance you can offer. Tell me, Commander, is serving aboard the Enterprise as extraordinary an experience as I've heard?
Every bit.
Good. Because I intend to convince Captain Picard that I'm the right choice for the job.
Job? Which job?